Hello everyone, this is an unboxing video of the Yi Cam which was launched by Xiaomi last year. I ordered these two via eBay. This is the camera and this is the box of the underwater housing, the original one, which is capable of withstanding about 40 meters of water pressure, I'm guessing. So alright, let's go ahead and open it. Alright, here's the cam, neatly packed, just like Xiaomi's boxing for the phones. Here's the camera. Let's see what's in the box. Here's the USB cable. Oops, draw that. It's alright. Cable, and then here's the battery, and this is the manual. I'm guessing this should be in Chinese. Yep. All right, so that's the Chinese manual. Here's the box. Let's check out what's in the underwater house. Alright, so here's the housing, here's the tripod adapter, and here's the screw. So the best part of the Yi Cam is that almost all accessories are compatible with the well-known GoPro camera accessories. And also you have quite a lot of accessories available that are not from the GoPro brand, which will help you in lessening the price, or rather I'd say cheaper price accessories. And here's a short manual. Going ahead, let's check out the camera itself. Right, it's neatly wrapped. Let me remove that. Alright, so here's the camera. Yeah, this is the power button as well as the mode button, which is between the photo and the video mode. Alright, let me try to get this closer to you. Alright, so here is a closer view of this. Yes, the button is the lens. As you can see here, it's photo and video mode alternative setting. Then here's the battery door and here's the USB card door. So let me remove this. It's quite tight. Okay. Here's the battery door. Let me remove the battery out of this car. Have this neat little flap which helps you to pull the battery out when you put in onto the camera. So let's put this on. Here are the contacts. The contacts are here as well. You can see. Okay, let's put this in. Compared to GoPro, there's quite a lot of gap between the border as well as the battery, which is covered by this rubber kind of a thing that keeps it in place. So the battery is on. Alright, so I have this 32GB class 10 micro SD card which I'm gonna use for this camera. It's an old one which I've been using for my GoPro. I have the GoPro Hero 3. So alright, it goes this way. careful with this small piece of plastic there. Press and hold the button, it turns on. Alright, so looks like the battery is low. So in case you didn't know, it gives out about three different colors: blue when the battery is full, and the pink when the battery is halfway through, and the red when it's almost about to die. So and this is the photo mode that it's on. So the reason I'm saying that is, so you have three LEDs here. I guess it's four. So it's 1, 2, 3, and 4. Yes, there are four LEDs. So if you are on the photo mode, the LEDs are off. Switch to the video mode, there are LEDs turned on, pretty bright. Alright, so that's good. So let me just show you how to record it. All you need to do is, you have this button at the top, click on it, and if it's blinking, it's recording. As simple as that. And the same button to stop. And let me switch on to the photo mode now. So when I press this, you will notice the light turn off, the red LED. There you go. And on photo it's pretty simple, just one click and you have a red flash, just about half a second delay. See that? Okay, that's pretty much it on the camera. Nothing much to do. Let me now put this in on to the waterproof housing and see how it feels in the hand. Okay. Oh, this is the waterproof housing. There's a cover here, let me get rid of that. It's also pretty sticky. So here's the power button, here's the button for the Wi-Fi, and the shutter button. And it's a very easy way to open this up. That's all. So you hold it like this, just push it from here, open it up. And this is how you open it. And this is where it goes. Like this. Alright, so just before that, there's one thing I forgot to mention is the Wi-Fi option on the camera. So when you turn it on, either on the photo or the video mode, and press and hold the button on the right, release it. There we go. So that's the blue LED, which usually denotes that the Wi-Fi is on. Okay, let me turn off the camera now and put it onto the waterproof housing. And close this. So this is how you close this. Sorry, just put it onto the groove on the back door and then press it on the front. There it is. It's a neat little packing. The quality is as good as GoPro, I'd say. Okay, well, let me start it off and see how it looks. There you go. Nice little color. Okay, let me switch on to the video mode. The button is pretty solid, and there you have your LED. It's pretty bright. Let's switch on the Wi-Fi. There we go. I just had to press it a bit harder. So let me see how the LED flashes. Okay, that's pretty bright. For the back LED, front is anyway, pretty big light. Notice there's nothing on the sides, no LEDs on the sides apart from this blue LED. I have this cover which I think I'll remove as well. Alright, this is a pretty good one. Now let me show you if it on a tripod. So as you can see here, now the camera itself has a tripod groove, so you don't really have to use this case to fit it onto the tripod, but again, you have, this is a more of a protective case. That's at least my usage compared to the underwater housing usage of this. So this protects the lens of the camera. So when you have this case on, you put this in for your tripod. Let me show you. And then once you have it in place, There you have it. Alright, so the charging of this camera is pretty simple. So we remove this back door. Let me turn off the camera first. And then the USB, the micro USB port goes here. The best part of this one is compared to GoPro. So this uses micro USB. At least the GoPro that I had, that is the Hero 3 Silver, used mini USB, which is pretty tough to find. And then you can charge this using a power bank as well, so which is good. Here's the HDMI port in case you want to fit it directly to TV and see your videos. Alright, let me now switch on the camera and let's try out the Wi-Fi functionality. This. And let me try to connect to it. So let's see what it says here. Yeah, so you see this. It's usually named as YDXJ. I'm not sure if you can see that, but it usually starts with a YDXJ. So it's a direct connect. Usually the password is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. Connect. Yep, there it is, connected. Okay. So here's the Yi camera app. Let me show that to you. If you can see the one with the red sphere. Let me start that off. And this is the connect button. There we go. It says update camera's firmware to improve performance. Let me do that in a bit. And here's the view of it. This is the photo mode. Let me show you the mode. So you have photo, timer, time lapse, burst, video, and then short video. So when I have a firmware upgrade, you would see some more options there. Okay, here's the video mode. I have a few settings here. I'm not sure if you can see. So it has different resolutions starting from 1080p, 960, 720, 480. 480 has the 240 fps frames per second, 720 has 120, 60 and 48, 1080p full HD has 60 frames per second, 30 and 24. Let's go on to the settings and check out. So I have quite a few settings here. Default mode for the camera, auto low light. Lens distortion adjustment and loop record, which is useful in case you are using it as a dash cam. And again the one other metering modes, which is good. And other tabs in that, so you can check out everything that you've clicked and download it as well. You can see that. Photo, mouse clicking, mouse shooting. It's pretty clear for a photo. And you can download it, add filters. Snapshots, it clicks all by itself, which is good. Okay, so this is it, folks. This is the YiCam. on low battery, and yeah, I think it's pretty good for the price it offers. I got it for about 7,500, including the waterproof casing, due to some eBay India coupon, and yeah, you should see a comparison video soon. Thank you.